Hello, I'm Sebastian. Welcome to Nine Knit Trees Podcast. Today I will summarize and review the book, Switch: How to Change Things. When Change is Hard is a compelling narrative that dives into the psychological and emotional frameworks underpinning change, authored by Chip Heath and Dan Heath. The book is centered around the idea that for change to occur, one must align the rational mind, the emotional mind, and the environment in which change is sought. Using a range of real-world examples, from individuals overcoming personal hurdles to large organizations implementing significant changes, the Heath brothers unravel the complexities of why change is often so difficult and provide actionable strategies for making change easier. Offering insights that are both intuitive and surprising, Switch illuminates the path to effect meaningful, lasting change in our lives, workplaces, and communities. I will give you key takeaways from this book. Firstly, the elephant and the rider. The elephant and the rider is a central metaphor in Switch, representing the two distinct parts of our minds that influence how we handle change. The elephant symbolizes the emotional, instinctual part of the brain, powerful but often short-sighted and seeking immediate gratification. The rider, on the other hand, represents the rational, analytical part of the brain that can plan and think long-term but can easily become overwhelmed with options and details. For successful change to happen, Chip and Dan Heath argue that we must direct the rider, motivate the elephant, and shape the path ahead. This involves setting clear, specific directions for the rider, finding emotional connections to motivate the elephant, and creating an environment that makes the desired action the easiest path forward. This metaphor beautifully encapsulates the struggle between emotion and rationality in the context of change, offering a framework for understanding and influencing human behavior in a way that promotes positive change. Secondly, find the bright spots. One of the critical strategies for effecting change outlined in Switch is the concept of finding the bright spots. Instead of focusing on what's wrong and trying to fix problems, the Heath brothers advocate for identifying and understanding what's working well and then cloning those successful elements. This approach shifts the focus from problem solving to leveraging existing strengths, making it easier to instigate positive change. By analyzing instances where success is already happening, leaders and change agents can learn what behaviors or strategies are effective and apply them more broadly. This encourages a more optimistic, resourceful approach to change, emphasizing solutions rather than dwelling on obstacles. For example, in a case study of malnutrition in Vietnam, focusing on what well-nourished kids were doing differently, the bright spots, led to a successful community-wide program to improve health. This principle demonstrates how positive outcomes can inspire and guide successful change initiatives. Thirdly, shrink the change. Shrinking the change is another potent concept from Switch that emphasizes the importance of breaking down seemingly overwhelming challenges into manageable steps. The idea here is to make the necessary changes appear less daunting and more achievable by tackling smaller, incremental goals. This approach helps to engage the elephant, the emotional and instinctive part of our psyche, by reducing its resistance to change due to fear or overwhelm. By celebrating small victories, individuals and organizations can maintain momentum and commitment to the change process. This technique is particularly effective in overcoming the paralysis that can accompany large-scale transformations, making it easier for people to start and stick with the changes needed. An example of this principle in action is the story of a car wash that issued loyalty cards with extra stamps already filled in. Customers were more likely to complete the card and remain loyal because the task of achieving a free car wash seemed more attainable. Shrink the Change illustrates the power of perception in the change process, highlighting how small gains can lead to significant achievements. Fourthly, grow your people. The strategy of growing your people involves fostering a mindset and identity that supports the desired change, emphasizing personal development and the idea of a growth mindset. Chip and Dan Heath argue that for change to be sustainable, individuals must see themselves as capable of evolving and adapting. This means cultivating a sense of identity that aligns with the goals of the change initiative and encouraging beliefs that support effort and persistence. One way to do this is by promoting a sense of purpose and connecting the change to individuals' values and self-conception. When people believe that their actions are part of a larger purpose and that they are the kind of person who supports these actions, they're more likely to embrace and sustain change. This approach is particularly effective for long-term changes that require ongoing commitment. Illustrating this, Switch discusses how a sense of identity played a crucial role in a successful environmental campaign, where appeals to civic duty and pride in community significantly improved recycling rates. Growing your people underscores the importance of the psychological components of change, demonstrating how enhancing self-perception and aligning change with core values can drive profound and lasting transformation. Lastly, script the critical moves. Scripting the critical moves is about eliminating ambiguity from the process of change by specifying clear, actionable steps that people need to take. This concept addresses the paralysis that can occur when individuals face change but are unsure of how to proceed. By providing a clear script to follow, the Heath brothers argue, you reduce hesitation and make it easier for the writer, the rational planning part of the brain, to make decisions and take action. This strategy is particularly useful in the early stages of change, where uncertainty is highest. It involves identifying and communicating the essential changes in behavior that are required for the change effort to succeed. An illustrative case from Switch involves an initiative to improve patient care by ensuring hospital staff followed a simple checklist of infection control practices. The clarity and simplicity of the prescribed actions, the script, led to a dramatic reduction in infection rates. Scripting the critical moves shows how providing a clear roadmap can help individuals navigate complex changes, significantly enhancing the likelihood of successful outcomes. In conclusion, Switch, How to Change Things When Change is Hard, is at its core a book for anyone who seeks to understand or implement change, whether on a personal scale or within larger organizations. The Heath brothers offer a treasure trove of psychological insights, practical advice, and hopeful stories that demonstrate how effective change is possible with the right approach. The book is especially beneficial for leaders, managers, educators, and anyone involved in change management, as it presents strategies that are both innovative and grounded in real-world applicability. The key takeaway is that change is less about sheer willpower and more about aligning our emotional and rational minds and shaping our environment in a way that makes new behaviors easier to adopt. Switch offers valuable lessons on navigating the multifaceted challenges of change, making it an essential read for anyone looking to make a meaningful difference in their personal life, their organization, or their community. If you would like to support Chip Heath, you can buy the book through the Amazon link I've provided in the podcast description. After reading the book, please let me know what you think and share your thoughts. See you around.